So I appreciate the tweets and some of the direct messages I'm getting on this issue at Ryder. Sounds like most of you agree that the school was way out of line. And, you know, and I agree. I mean, I think the challenge we have in today's world is that we lack courage at many levels. So the excuse is often given, well, there's a federal law. What can we do? And I keep thinking, like, you know, how many times throughout history has, you know, the fact that there was a law been used as an excuse to do something wrong? So the law shouldn't be the only, like, we can think, right? And I think back when I was in the Marine Corps, and one of the things that was drilled into our heads is that you're obligated to follow lawful orders. So what that leaves open for interpretation is it possible that you could be given an order that you shouldn't follow? And yes, that's the, you know, the training in the Marine Corps was designed to have you think. And I think today we're not thinking anymore. We're just following. And now you got a young man who's been tossed out of school, Jersey kid from Passaic County, a former student at Ryder. Now he's gone. And now he's got this tag on him. And you're so now you got like a kid that is effectively branded a sexual predator for doing what literally most of the college kids are out there doing. Now, if the backlash of this is that these 18 and 19 year old kids will stop getting drunk and having sex, that's not a bad thing to have happen either. Having said that, don't you think part of the problem here is that we are on two sides. One, that we've got weak-kneed, spineless cowards running our universities. And I'm trying not to mince my words. I just want you to get the point. And on the other side, we've got a culture of children that we're sending out into the world without being properly trained and coached. And, you know, and I'm here having learned lessons of being a young idiot for a time. And here I'm standing and now I'm able to talk to you about it. And it's not to say that, you know, kids are not going to act like young idiots. They are. But at what point do you say that, first of all, you get these two kids in a room and they've been drinking and they take their clothes off and then something happens and all of a sudden it's rape. Now, could that happen? Yes. Yes, it does happen. But it's like when you paint with this broad brush, number one, I'd like to see an America where we, and I'd love to see New Jersey lead the way on this. I think New Jersey ought to completely turn the tide and go for a younger drinking age. I'd like to see the drinking age lowered to 18. And I think you'd get less of this hoarding and hiding in the dorms. Because let's face it, look at the eating clubs at Princeton. Right? They're all getting drunk is what they're doing. And they're all underage. I mean, everybody knows it and nobody talks. Look at the fraternities in any of these universities. What do you think they're doing? So consensual sex, if you want to say it's not consensual, if you're drunk, okay, but maybe we ought to do something about the drinking then. And I'm saying you got to go back. You're never going to ban it completely. They've tried. It's illegal now. So clearly your 21-year-old drinking age has failed. And labeling every guy as a predator, well, that's not doing anybody any good because guess what? You're now allowing the real predators to blend in with the rest of college co-eds. There's a problem. There's a problem.